Flight attendants and cabin crew, please prepare for departure. Guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's look is this flight attendant that got into a plane crash. I wanted to do something scary, but also something still glam. So this is what I came up with. Burn victim from a plane crash. She has a hole in her head and her nose is broken and she's just bleeding everywhere. I think this look came out pretty cool. So if you guys are interested on how I got this look, then keep on watching.
Hey guys, the first thing that I'm going to do is grab this color by MAC, and this is the color Saddle, and this is one of my favorite transition colors. I absolutely love it, but what I'm going to do is same thing I always do. I'm just starting on the outer corner of my eye and then just working my way up into the crease and making sure that everything is just super seamless. Next, we have this palette by Pop Beauty. And we're gonna use that color right there, the deep red shade, and basically just copy what we did earlier and just go on the outer corner of the eye and then bringing the rest of the product up into the crease, but really trying to focus the product on the outer corner of the eye. Going in with a deeper shade, this is Foley by MAC. And again, just focusing the product on the outer corner of the eye. I really wanted to give more depth on the outer corner of the eye. So I'm really focusing that product right there and close to the lash line. Next, I'm just going in with this brush. It doesn't have product on it. It looks like it does, but it doesn't. I'm just using this brush to basically blend everything together and make sure everything meshes really well. Next shade is Beaches and Cream by Makeup Geek. This color is so perfect. It's the perfect bone color. And basically, I'm just going to put this all over my lid. Next, I'm going in with this eyeliner by CoverGirl. This eyeliner is no joke, you guys. It literally stays on your eye all day. Like at the end of the night when I'm washing my face, I literally have to scrub this off. I'm loving this eyeliner. All right, I just popped some lashes on really quick. And next, I'm going to go in with this foundation by NARS. I'm like loving this foundation, by the way. The coverage is great. I love the finish. And the color matches me perfect. So basically, I'm just going to do the same thing as any other human being would do. Put the foundation all over my face. And then I'll buff it out with a beauty blender. For concealer, I'm going in with this Too Faced concealer. Loving this stuff too. The coverage is also really great on this, and loving the color, because for me, concealers, sometimes I feel like the undertones in my eye will still shine through, but with this, I feel like it does pretty well for the coverage. Next, we're going to go ahead and set everything, and I'm going to go in with this Hello Flawless face powder by Benefit. And I'm just going to stipple this product all over my face until I feel like my entire face is covered. With the same product, I'm just using a different brush, more flat brush. And I am just stippling this product underneath my eye. And next, I'm going in with the Casino Bronzer by NARS and really warming up my skin. Going back in with this deep red shade from Pop Beauty, I'm just going to put that on my bottom lash line. And I'm going to blow it out just a little bit. Going in with Foley by MAC, I'm just going to deepen the lash line just a little bit. So I wanted it to be a little bit more smoky. So now I'm going in with the color Sketch by MAC and just trying to keep the product really close to the lash line. Next, I'm going in with Desert Rose by MAC, and I'm just going to apply this to my cheeks and then to the apples of my cheeks. For lips, I decided to go in with the Vava Plump Make Me Melt color by Buxom. And this is a really beautiful, rich, like brownish, reddish color. And I thought it went just perfect with this look. All right, now it's time for the scary stuff. I'm going to use this red and black color from the Makeup Forever Flash Palette. And basically just mix them. And I'm just putting that on my inner nostril. And then I'm just kind of like spreading it upward, But I mean, you guys can do whatever kind of technique you want or however you want. I just decided to make it look like I had like a busted nose. Now I'm going in with this blood. This is like the scab blood. It's a little bit of a thicker consistency, so it looks a little bit different than regular blood. So I'm just basically putting that on the inner part of my nostril and then just kind of sporadically putting it different places just so it looks more realistic. In order to make this gash on my nose, I'm basically just using the same product I used earlier and just stippling the product onto my nose and then going in with the same blood, the scabby blood, and just making it look like there's blood basically coming out of my skin. Now I'm just going to go in with the red shade and stipple this product onto my forehead. This is basically just the backing of the scab that we're about to create. Okay, so next you're going to need some clear latex, a tissue, and not to blow your nose, it's actually going to be for the scab. So basically we're just going to put this latex all around this little red part and just get small pieces of the tissue and just start sticking them all over the scab area. Next I'm going in with my NARS foundation and I'm just going to cover the scab area so that it meshes better with my skin. Going back in with the flash palette, we're going to use the black and red colors, and we're going to try to create more of a like bruised or burn kind of look. So we're just using the black and the red to try to create that. And with a pair of tweezers, you want to just kind of make a hole and just be a little careful just because you don't want to take the whole scab off, but you want to create a hole so that way it looks like you have an actual hole in your head. And with the black and red, I'm just putting a little bit of shading on the inside, and then I'm going back in with this scabby blood and just putting it on the inside of the scab and on the outside of the wound so it looks more realistic. Next I'm going in with stage blood. Stage blood is a lot more liquidy, so I'm just grabbing as much product as I feel is necessary, and then I just kind of press against my skin to try to make it drip down my face. With the same stage blood, I'm basically just doing the same thing, just putting it close to my hairline and then just putting a lot of pressure to try to get it to drip down my face.
That is it for this tutorial. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Hopefully it was easy for you guys to follow along. If you guys did like it, don't forget to give me a thumbs up. And if you guys aren't subscribed already, don't forget to subscribe. I will see you guys in my next tutorial. Bye guys.
Ouch, Charlie, that really hurt.
Well, that's gonna leave a scar.